another day, another debacle. God, I groaned. How productive these hours would have been if, instead of utility stuff like my cell phone charger, I had forgotten those recent misfortunes. Looked around, couldn't find anyone who would offer me a charger or perhaps sympathy. As I sat with my hands on my head, it struck me, your vibe attracts your tribe. Your vibe attracts your tribe. The gadget with 1% charge resembled me. How, you ask? Well, a person with a dying hope carrying a device with a dying battery. The two are helpless, besides being nearly powerless and almost useless. I huffed, then tossed the mobile back in my bag. I'm so useless. Yeah, I huffed and tossed the mobile back in my bag. The dejected me went back to dealing with the Monday blues, unaware of the bolt from the blue that was waiting for me in the upcoming 3.5 hours. Workflow came to a halt. My heart skipped its beat. Goosebumps consumed my skin. My ears were surrounded with smoke and heat. When the same routine ringtone was heard, I fumbled my bag with trembling fingers, accepted the call, even talked for a good whole minute. Whoa! I was intrigued, baffled, thrilled, and all other exclamatory adjectives in those unbelievable moments of miracle. Calm down. Tried to contain myself with various logics and failed. Failure has never felt so sweet. Since those precise seconds of astonishing occurrence, 114 minutes have passed. Curiosity was getting better of me. I opened the bag again to take a look. My phone, my gadget, it was still working, it was still alive. Next step, took a leap of faith. I called again. My cell phone survived again. Whoa! Approximately 5.5 hours, 1% charge, and it is still working. It is still working. आज मैं ऊपर आसमान नीचे आज मैं आगे समझ रहा है नीचे यस यस आज मैं ऊपर आसमान नीचे आज मैं आगे जमाना है पीछे I could feel a fresh energy stirred in me. My eyes were gleaming and sparkling, and I didn't want to chase the magic by constant checking. So the focus was shifted on other, or rather say the task or the job that I was supposed to be doing. And man, Clark's hands were acting like a real moron in that period, crawling and leisurely dragging. After the weight of an eternity, I was finally allowed to commute. I rushed to see my little buddy. After the peak, my happiness was bursting at the seams from morning to evening. 1% charge, operating and illuminating my phone accompanied me till I was 50 meters away from my apartment. As I entered my residence lane, I could see the screen, black and blank. It didn't disappoint me though. No, really. I think I understood. The machine was tired. It saw no results of its struggle. So, it gave up. Okay? It gave up. Hey. Take back your words. My phone wasn't a quitter. Okay? It was a fighter. It gave its best even when it was at its lowest, even when it was at its 1%.